Question answer session will be at the end. Students, if you have any questions related to the today's webinar or topic, please write it in chat box. Thank you. Good afternoon to one and all. On behalf of BK Birla College of Arts, Science and Commerce Kalyan, I would like to extend a warm welcome to our esteemed keynote speaker, Shri Kapil Pathare sir, Director, VIP Clothing Limited, and member, BK Birla College Governing Council. Respected Dr. Naresh Chandra sir, Director, Education. Respected Dr. Avinash Patil sir, Principal of the College. Respected Dr. Swapna Samil madam, Principal, BK Birla Knight College. Vice Principals, Head of the Departments, all faculty members, professionals, and my dear students, participants. I would like to introduce today's webinar on impact of COVID-19 life as an entrepreneur, which is jointly organized by the Department of Commerce and Accountancy. India needs entrepreneurs for many reasons, but two important among us them are, first, to create employment and wealth, and second, to get the most out of existing opportunities. Our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji, in his address to the nation on 12th May 2020 said, the country should view the COVID-19 crisis as an opportunity to achieve economic self-reliance. In his address to the nation, he stressed on the importance of promoting local products, called it as Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan or Self-Reliant India Mission. The objective of the webinar is to fast learning about growing significance of entrepreneurship in our country. The discussion will also highlight the positive implication of current pandemic situation of COVID-19 on entrepreneurship and on our economy. So, with these words, I would like to invite our respected principal, Dr. Avinash Patil sir, for the welcome address. Sir.
Sir, mic.
Good afternoon. Respected Shri Kapil Pathare ji, Director, VIP Clothing Limited, Mumbai. And member of Governing Council, BK Birla College, Kalyan. Dr. Naresh Chandra sir, Director, Education, BK Birla College, Kalyan. Dr. Swapna Samil, in charge principal of BK Birla Knight College, Kalyan. Mr. Bipin Wadekar, Vice Principal, Commerce Faculty. Dr. Vrinda Nishandar, Ms. Lakshita Soni, Dr. Anuradha Hastak, departmental colleagues from Commerce Faculty, other faculty members and dear students. So all of you are aware of this current pandemic situation of COVID-19, which we are experiencing from the month of March. Since the March 18 around, we are at home, taking care of ourselves and our family. We request all of you to be safe and at home and take your proper care of yourself, your family, your friends and neighbors also. In this current situation of COVID-19, the economy has suffered a setback. The many business houses, they have changed their modalities and their business practices, their ways of business and many more. And we thought of arranging a webinar for all of you to know about what are the changes in these business strategies. And hence the Department of Accountancy and Commerce, they are organizing a webinar titled Impact of COVID-19, Life as an Entrepreneur. And for this webinar, we have with us Shri Kapil Pathare ji, director of VIP Clothing, and he is also a member of governing council of our college. We extend a warm welcome to Shri Kapil Pathareji, who has accepted our invitation and happily will be spending his evening with all of us discussing the life of an entrepreneur in this current situation of COVID-19. We also have with us our director, Dr. Naresh Chandra sir, who is always a constant source of inspiration for all of us. We welcome him also for this webinar, along with all our colleagues and as well as all our students for this webinar. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your welcome address. Now, I would like to request Principal Sri Bipin Chandra Wadekar, sir, to introduce our respected keynote speaker, Sri Kapil Pathareji. Wadekar, sir.
Today's keynote speaker, respected Mr. Kapil Pathare, respected Director Dr. Naresh Chandra, Principal Dr. Avinash Patil, In-Charge Principal Knight College Dr. Swapna Samir, my colleagues, present faculty members, professionals and dear students, I am very happy to introduce such a young, dynamic leader, Mr. Kapil Jaikumar Pathare, is a director of VIP Clothing and was introduced as director at the age 21. Since beginning, he has been inclined more towards operations of management functionary besides other functions. He focused more on various aspects of manufacturing of innerwear goods with his clear concept of quality of product and services. He believes in success of business. Personal depends on right understanding of human resources and their approaches, skills, and values of those who work in organization. Mr. Kapil Pathare did pursue his master in business administration after graduation in commerce discipline and has equipped himself on professional front by undergoing various seminars, conferences to upgrade himself. Mr. Pathare acquired a knowledge of business procedures and technical aspect by being with the people on floor. The company has won many fashion awards for more than two decades. To name few are Abby's Golden 2005, Golden Scale Trophy 2007-8, the Brand of the Year Women's Innerwear by CMAI, Golden Scale Trophy 2007-8, Brand of the Year Men's Innerwear by CMAI, Golden Scale, and many more awards are there at the credit of VIP Group. The company has been continuously engaged in branding of products and emerging its image from mass brands to premium brands. Mr. Kapil Pathare is a consistent follower of change management thinking proceeded with Kaizen and principles of just in time in the areas of inventory management. He always states time is the essence of management and therefore he believes in timely delivery of results for the development and prosperity of the company. He associated with many institutions and colleges as committee member. He is governing council member, B.K. Birla College, Autonomous Kalyan, and heading sports committee to promote sports of our college. As an author, he has penned his first book, Cricket to Corporate, which was inaugurated by former Indian wicketkeeper, Mr. Kiran More, where he has stroked the cricketing field strategy to the field of boardroom. See, such a multidimensional personality is present with us. Now I am requesting him to take charge of the mic and enlighten young minds to grow future entrepreneurs. Thank you, sir, please.
Hello, good afternoon. The screen is visible, please.
Yes, sir, screen is visible.
Perfect, thank you. First of all, each and every student, as well as professors of BK Birla College, for giving me this opportunity to be my dear students, it's a privilege to be back to college. And why I say this is, I am a student of BK Birla College, and it feels such a pride that today you are amongst one of those gurus of yours who have inspired me and what you achieve. And I am really obliged to Shri Naresh Chandraji, sir, for giving me this good opportunity to interact born in studying in BK Birla College and today running an empire of an industry turnover business. I would like to share the insights of what exactly is the pre and the post impact of COVID. But along with that, what kind of solutions that one need to take to sustain and to survive. I'm past 6 months now getting used to this pandemic situation. We are all going through an unprecedented times in this. The year 2020 has been a unique challenge for all of us as an individual and as a corporation. And I'm sure come back and repose a lot of challenges here. So before I take you to the slides, COVID-19 has acted global. When I say global economy, it has absolutely brought disruptions to the whole universal any individual or any institution to really go through, and hence we say that it is. But at the same time, it has brought complete individual life to a standstill. What has been the we say that there has been a decline in economy across the globe, which has brought the India's GDP to 2%, which was correct. And when I say that, this is all when we actually went into the lockdown where the economy started declining as compared to the other countries. But what did so we say that we did early lockdown in the month of March, and when we came to know that yes, the pandemic is now country and the complete economy, our Prime Minister also came forward to announce that social very crucial factor. Immediately, medical facilities started increasing across the channel. Most important was the closing of, and which really bought a lot of as compared to other countries. We also closed a lot of state borders because India being densely populated in terms of mappings also. Hence, closing of borders are one of the key factors, and we took it in a very, very rigorous way. Our public transport, when it comes to Mumbai, obviously local trains are the lifeline of Mumbai, and we say that this particular public transport obviously now we hear that with the unlock situation, government is planning to open up one by one to boost the economic status of the doctors, the police, the government bodies, and the front end staff who did a fantabulous work during this pandemic situation. Thank yourselves. So these are some of the steps that India took it, which was very, very important for bringing the safety precautions of each and every individual. When it's corporate level or when it's touch the company, there is a sudden lockdown basically that has happened. Most of the employees now today have been given the work from home culture was never so popular in India. Even always the routine structure in European countries, but now with this pandemic situation, India had no choice, but employees had most of the to name IT companies obviously have gone working from home. They have already announced till December 31st work from home. We have got used to the system as a corporate. Also, if you see the change in education system due to this pandemic situation, that have been now switched to, you all might have, or you all might have gone through each and every day, learning about the digital way of the social distance being very mandated, and it was most important that one have to follow this during their lockdown. As I said, you shut from 6 months, which is the local trains. The air travel was completely suspended for 6 months. So overall, I would say that completely, and the first 3 months was a very, very challenging activity for each and every individual. To take forward, because never in the life anyone has witnessed such kind of situation, and never in the life any situation can completely disrupt the overall globe. So I think not everyone was, or not no one was ever prepared for this pandemic. All this without and the crisis that one will have to face. Obviously, as I said, that employees given work from home, our industry also, since April onwards, eventually we also learned that all this e-learning and digital way of learning was 2 years in the, but probably no one was trying to adapt that new way of digital learning, because way to learn. Hello.
Hello, sir.
Just
for a minute, we can talk.
You are audible, sir. Your PPT is invisible.
Now, it's okay.
No. Yes, 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 sir.
Yeah. So, I was talking about taking place. Yes, is the PPT visible, please?
Yes, yes, sir.
Not visible.
No, PPT is not visible.
Not visible, sir. Share your screen here.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, it is visible.
So we learned about the and how that the crisis can be now changed into opportunity. So what did the company do basically? We are now into crisis. So how do we cope up? So when there comes a crisis, there has to be an opportunity, and very few of we have to keep sourcing for new applications for various sources. We have to recoup the strategy and we have to adapt to the situation. Here to all my dear students who have been now been into learning this digital way, we all know that how this crisis has struck a very important decision that we need to start having e-learning, and hence the Microsoft team discussed and launched. So these are the opportunity that we need to start the digital learning, and at the same time the source is basically the Microsoft Team application that you all might have now got used to it. And of course, we need to adapt to the situation, the new situation, the new normal, which business or in our entrepreneurship. Adaptability to the situation is very, very important. Everything was shut down. We shut down our factories, we shut down our. But we need to keep going back. The motivation level amongst the employees, the motivation levels among the team members, and we need to keep the momentum going to the video conferencing meetings all the time. Morning 9 o'clock to evening 6 o'clock were completely. The timings were even stretched. In work from home, I guess most of you might be aware that the timings have been stretched apart and there were no time used to have it during the office hours. So recouping and adapting to situation is a very, very important parameter. Change in vision to achieve the goal. If you see the three square boxes, those are the traditional to reach the, but a very clever man tries to roll the box and he tries to push it with the flow of the gravity. I say that the goal remains the same for everyone, but the visionary will have to be twisted, or the visionary will have to be changed in this pandemic situation. New ideas. You will have to bring a lot of in business, lot of innovations in taking forward the new way of mechanism of the business. Bring innovation. If you do not get new idea, you can see the people with the umbrella who have synced the entrepreneur, it can sync, and hence it is very, very to spark the ideas, to create new ideas and float your business in this flooded situation also. In this unprecedented times, advantage in crisis, and I will give some example of us as a company. I came in. What did the newspaper company did? The newspaper company started digital utilization of all the newspapers on our mobile phone. WhatsApp digital newspapers of all the publications, and hence because it was considered that we should not touch any papers which are coming from outside, and it's a real important element. Advanced technology. We started doing our e-learning classes in the college schools. We as a company, we did meetings. We in fact also tried to meet our sales channel trade partners, our people, connected them, the Zoom platform or the video conferencing platform, which actually made a point that we connected each and everyone in our company in the that in such difficult times we are all together. Online education, of course, we did as a company because we are into an innovative business. Everything was shut down. One of a few of our workers, which was inside the factory in our Tamil Nadu unit, and some of the workers actually could not travel back to their hometown due to the lockdown. thinking, and our team came up with the idea of developing and producing masks. And today, here we are, that a company which was only being considered as a mask as a channel, and I'm happy to share that we have almost sold more than 10 lakh pieces of mask and contributed for the safety of the citizens of India. So, as I said, various organizations tried different way to cover this sourcing of business. Like garment industry, they turned to mass manufacturing, changed to e-paper fest, online school education system, adapted the technology, and not just the education system, but even the doctor facility. The fitness centers started using online facility, and very, very important was our daily necessity of life, the groceries which we used to, they also the online digital mode by means of application or by means of WhatsApp digital. So how is the lifestyle before COVID? Lifestyle before COVID was social lifestyle. We were more towards going for birthday parties, going for celebrations, meeting friends, family over the weekends, outing and free movement, a lot of some used to drive down, say from Mumbai to Pune, Mumbai to Lonavala on a weekend, come back. There was no time bound as such to come back. And family was actually given a very, very. But what happens the post COVID today in this last 6 months that everybody has faced is, one is there is no celebrations. There is no birthday celebrations going on, which means everything is. Actually, in the pandemic situation was so fresh. As I said, the first 3 months before the unlock situation, the air was so fresh, pollution was very less, but we all have the roads were vacant, but there were no long drives happening. What we did was we actually spent during those period a very, very quality. The efficiency in a lockdown. So work from home actually for some of the employees the time in terms of travel, and in fact it shown more productive results. So in a city, Delhi, Bangalore, where traffic conditions are very, very high. I'm sure even the traffic conditions in Kalyan city is gone really high. So today has saved a lot of time of travel. And also during this situation, one has to have a meeting with a channel partner in Delhi. We can shift the meeting to Bangalore. So what my point is, those days of traveling, planning of traveling to Delhi, planning of traveling to Bangalore was very. Hello. Sound break, right? Okay. So for most of the employee has been very, very effective. And similarly, I would say that during the online learning and education, every student actually could focus. They got for during the time of school lectures or college lectures. But most important was and after the lectures, the student could focus on hobbies and other activities, which actually was not possible earlier due to lack of time. The key to perform at your best during this tense of your life is now that one has to stand and fight. Also, one has to single-mindedly on the solution. What happens many a times, people will start thinking that the country, COVID has attacked the earth, but now we have no other option. We have no other situation. But dear students, with every problem, there is a solution. And those solution can only come if we start focusing on the solutions rather than focus. Many a times, it is a human tendency that we start focusing on the problems, but we do not focus on solutions. And in a business, one has to keep thinking so it doesn't work. There is always a plan B. One has to keep ready with him. And we have to always single so that it is stuck to the path, to the goal that we have thought of. Let me share you some few insights of it. We started the safety measures the moment the lockdown started. We thought that the government declared about the unlocking of the industry. Some of the common safety measures we started were the sanitization and the social distancing, of course. But most important was during that lockdown period, we created the SOPs for our SOPs for our staff. We have standard operating procedure for our offices. We have standard operating procedures for our all factories. So these are very, very crucial that one has to standard operating, and that is where the key element of entrepreneurship will come handy, because these are some of the guidelines that one has to start following. But most important is all these guidelines will have to be ready before the thing starts unlocking. And hence we had the members and came to a solution that what should be the right guidelines. The most awaited results. Now when I talk about the results, which is the vaccine, this is what everybody is waiting for. We all are waiting for the vaccine to come in, but we all don't know when will be that. But till then, till the vaccine comes in, we have to keep following the social distancing, the sanitization, the using of mask, avoiding the crowded places. We need to take such kind of precautions, and we need to adhere to the lifestyle. So because precaution is always, we have to keep thinking that we cannot think that unless the vaccine gets launched, our business will have to start post And hence I say the plan B action will always be ready with us. Change in approach. The only I like to share is that we need to change in our approach to be positive. In last 6 months, on a lighter side, nobody wants. We need to be positive in thoughts. We need to think about adapting our positive approach and mental barriers. So in my slide, if you see the three people, the three arrows, they depict the three people. Because there is a wall in between, how three of them actually are thinking how to cross the wall and reach the goal. The wall, one is thinking of the hole and going beneath the wall, and the other one is thinking break the wall and go. So there are three different approaches to go. The important part is the positive approach, which is very, very important in the business. Just giving you, as I said, what we did in as a company, we did launching of our mask business. Varieties of mask. I'm happy to even share that as a company, which we would not have thought about doing this, we also entered recently launching N95 mask. As a brand, we are present overall in all the form of retail outlets. So this is one challenge that I would say probably we would channel, but this was due to COVID, I would say, and the pandemic. A very rightful proverb. My favorite character, nothing in this world, not even our troubles. So if troubles can't be permanent, if nothing is permanent, then why? Since I say that this all pandemic, this all tough time are just a temporary phase of mind. India will fight back. India is fighting back. Even this webinar that we do on through our the seminar, we are doing it through a webinar, I would say, is also one challenge that COVID has put forward in the education system. This challenge and come as an aspect of getting on through this digital platform is something that a solution that everyone has found out. Let us all come together and defeat this pandemic. Where we were on an original platform. Thank you, friends. While I conclude my slides, I would like to say that one battle against COVID, it is very, very important for us to come together and celebrate our culture, our festivals that with the Ganpati, the Ganesh Chaturthi, we will be welcoming Navratra, we will be welcoming Diwali, but we all need to celebrate our culture, but at the same time take precautions. There are various industries, I would say, like travel tourism industry, the airline industry, they have been the hospitality industry, they all have been affected very much, I would say. The gems a lot in this pandemic situation, but as I said that the automobile industry eventually had affected. As we move approach towards the festival season, probably this industry might, our innerwear industry was a little bit affected, and hence I would say that we took this opportunity to manufacture masks, and the retails have already eventually, as the festival season comes, I think India would definitely try to come back, and the whole economy would try to come back. One thing is very sure that actually we are seeing last 6 months from entrepreneurship that yes, we are facing a tough situation, but as we progress and as we go by, one thing is very clear. And as we go forward, we have to adapt each and every exigency of this business environment. I am sure that with such shall see a goodbye to this COVID as well. Thank you, friends, for being here. I would like to share one small video on this. A small video also.
Hello, sir.
Hello, Nishandar, madam.
Video we are unable to see. Sir is showing video, no? Sir is going to show. Hello, sir. Okay, I would request now Anuradha Hastak, madam.
Hello, Vinod, can you play that video?
एक मिनट मला बघतो, मी चेक करतो माझ्याकडे व्हिडिओ आहे का. पीपीटी होती.
हॅलो पाटारे सर, यू हॅव म्युटेड युअर माइक सर.
सो थँक्यू व्हेरी मच स्टुडंट्स फॉर हिअरिंग मी आउट.
सर व्हिडिओ यू आर ट्राइंग अगेन.
सर व्हिडिओ, हां व्हिडिओ प्ले नाही झाला सर.
कॅन आय ट्राय इट वन्स अगेन?
यस सर, प्लीज.
विनोद सर
हा बोला सर.
तो व्हिडिओ तुमच्याकडे घ्या आणि तोपर्यंत क्वेश्चन आन्सर आणि हे चालू होईल ते मेल करतील तुम्हाला किंवा मला केलं तर मी तुम्हाला पाठवतो आणि मग शेवटी पाहिजे तर तो व्हिडिओ स्क्रीन करू.
चालेल चालेल, डन. तोपर्यंत मग क्वेश्चन आन्सर घ्या.
येस
सर, मला मेल करा तुम्ही.
Hello, good evening to all. I am Dr. Anuradha Hastak, Head Department of Accountancy. Sir, we really thank you for a wonderful presentation, and which is based on that change is constant and inevitable. So actually your presentation is a very good example that how one can survive positively whenever there are certain challenges and how we can look at them very positively. Sir, our student has asked how the impact of COVID-19 on the farmers and businesses related to that. So that student wants to know about it. Please, Pathare sir.
could you just repeat the question once again, please?
Yeah, the student wants to know that what is the effect of pandemic on the farmers and how they should look at it positively because of this pandemic situation.
Oh, it's a very yes. So it's a very live question because, as I said, that during the times of lockdown, to the likes of the farmer. Why farmers? Because one is the farmers who are actually into farming cotton was the most impacted. Textile industry was also impacted, and hence.
Sir, you are not audible.
Can you listen to me?
Now you are audible, sir.
Now we can.
Impacted farmer was from the textile. The farmer who was actually growing cotton, and hence, because textile industry was. Supply the cotton to the industry, and hence the whole cycle of the textile chain was impacted. Eventually, the farmers who were actually more on groceries item probably might not have got that much impacted because in the the items were highly required. So I would say if a percentage to fix what kind of percentage a farmer was impacted, then 50% or so. Yes.
Yes, sir. The second question students want to know that. Sir, they want to learn from your example. They say that you have become a director of such a big company at a very young age. So what are your feelings at that time and how you say tried to become at such a high position? When you become a director at a very young age, what were your feelings and what you thought at that time to become a very successful entrepreneur?
Yeah. First of all, I have actually come from a family of business.
Okay.
Father, late Shri Jaikumar, also being one of the governing council member of BK Birla, and empire of VIP. So blood was always there into our family having a business. So yeah. When I approach after my it was not that straight I had to become a director of the company, because being a family business.
Yeah, but even after that, son, you have to struggle a lot. Man. Yeah,
but yeah, still, as a son of a family man, I had to go through the process, and actually, I went through technical knowledge about how to actually learn about textile industry, and hence I said that the journey of becoming a director was learning from step. As good as learning the numerical before learning too.
Yeah, sir. What we have seen in your presentation that you have taken the situation in a positive manner, and instead of producing or in addition to producing your other products, you have also started the production of masks. So how this idea came to your mind, and so how you have got the say workers, and how you kept your factory on at such a difficult situation when there were so many workers say traveled to their native places, and how you have taken this challenge positively?
Yeah, so our factory roughly about 1,000, and in this lockdown period we were only left with 50 workers who actually stay inside the. So normally we have 200, 300 workers staying inside our premises, where we provide them facility to stay and food.
Yes.
I'm proud to also say that complete factory is dominated by women's worker, and we are a woman empowerment company. So with the lockdown coming in, return to their native place. Some of them could not go, the 40-50 workers, because there was already lockdown implemented in their area, and they come from. Considering what they will do now in this pandemic situation, the teams thought that we have then why can't we convert from the available resources and opportunity to make mask, and hence from the availability of resource.
Yes, sir.
We started gradually.
Sir, you are not audible in between. Your voice is breaking.
That with the available resources and with the available opportunity, one has to start taking decisions and start implementing the same.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, can you hear me, please?
Now you can. In between, your voice is not, it's breaking, so we are not able
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
So now what I want to say is, with the availability of resources,
again breaking it is, sir. Your voice is not audible.
Yeah.
Hello, sir.
Availability of resources. Okay, I think we can pass the mic, because there is some connect
issue of connectivity at your place.
Connectivity issues.
Yeah. Sure, sir. So, but actually, my dear students. So what you have learned from his speech and answers, that whenever you are an entrepreneur, you have to take quick decisions. You have to adapt yourself to the changing situation, and you have to take certain decisions. Say, actually, they have taken a decision of manufacturing the masks only because those workers who were inside there or who were there in the factory, they should get some earnings, and or they should have some work, they should also get the money for the survival. And considering that, they have started the production of masks. So it's a very good idea, sir, and so innovative idea. And again, as you shared with us, that there are women workers, most of the women workers working in your factory. Listening to that, we are also very happy, considering your concern towards your female workers in the factory. So we are very much proud of you, sir. With this, now I request our director, Dr. Naresh Chandra, sir, to give his closing remarks.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sir, you can switch on your video also.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We had a very good presentation by Mr. Kapil Pathare, our esteemed member of Governing Council, and he's like our family member, very close. His father and we all have worked together for several years. Late Shri Jaikumar Pathare ji, we remember with gratitude while he had made presentation today. A great entrepreneur and self-made man. My young friends, you had some question. You have become director at a very young age. This is the point you have referred to Mr. Kapil Pathare. If I say lightly, he has been, we say not born and brought up. He rightly answered the family of a business. And if you see the biography of his father, we should read. We have that in our library. As a student of commerce or management, or even as a person to see success in life, he is one such example. He has been proud of Maharashtra, who has, from starting from scratch to hundreds of crores project worth, there have been very few such entrepreneurs from our state of Maharashtra, and he has been one great success story. And this has been taken over by both the sons of late Shri Jaikumar Pathare. He also continued to live with all of us together at Kalyan. He rightly tried to say that believing in women empowerment very strongly, converting challenges into opportunity every time. He must have experienced several new ideas, and so is being followed by Mr. Kapil Pathare and his elder brother, Mr. Sunil Pathare. I just want to add with that today there were some technical hitches. Would be very happy that we have that slide, this video presentation, and when he had interacted in the seminar hall, it was full of great warmth and what a person can do coming out with such, from such rich family, but always remained simple, always remained grounded, no any kind of wrong doing. It did not strike. They developed hobby in sports, performances, creativity, and utilize the time in the best possible manner. So even if you have money, you can rise to, you can make it further strong. And that is a value. We must respect and our value system. My dear young friends, you may become big, but if you forget in becoming big to respect your elders, parents, brothers, sisters, I'm sure that is not the purpose of getting educated. We at Birla College wish to nurture the values, inculcate values, which will always inspire you, will always guide you to respect everyone in the system. And very rightly he was trying to say when he said, look, I have prepared myself, I have developed myself by going through training programs, by going through how textile industry, how to learn technology. What I do is not enough. Where I am going to work, what is expected me from me to learn. Today all of us are learning the ways to attend lectures online, the ways to give lectures, deliver lectures online, e-content development, project, assignment, and so on and so forth. So in the light of all this, it is very necessary that we should remain always very active and ready to learn. My dear student friends, you have taken admission in Birla College. This is not enough. We have been talking to you all. You must think very seriously. What is the goal of, what is the purpose of your life? How you want to develop yourself? How you want to shape your career? You must put on paper. Must discuss with your parents. Discuss with your teachers. This is my thought, this is my dream, and how best I can realize this. And for that, you must try to develop your own action plan. I'm sure right thoughts, right dreams, translating them to reality by right ways will make you a happy and successful person and a proud person. Today we all feel very happy to see that Mr. Kapil Pathare is doing so well. He has adapted. He has taken things very seriously and working in the right direction. He is also helping in promoting, is it all sports lover? I don't know, I may not, I think he did not tell that his father had been great lover of cricket, so both the sons. And it is for this reason he gave the name to both the sons. When Mr. Sunil was born, the Sunil Gavaskar was at the helm, and so he named first son Sunil. Second, by the time Mr. Kapil Dev had come and he's been so fascinated and passion, full of passion, that second son Kapil, that is a love for cricket and so on and so forth. Is a great, we have been associated with, working with, we had had many value-added activities organizing, working for the cause of our city, our area, for education, and for higher education in particular. sports, cultural, and so many activities. Before I conclude, thank you, Mr. Kapil Pathare. We are very happy and we will have more such interactions. But my dear young friends,
thank you, sir.
This time is, as he rightly said, very unprecedented pandemic situation. Everyone is suffering. You must take your care, must maintain safe distance wherever needed. Wherever you go, you must take care. You must take care of your parents, brothers, sisters, and the society in the best possible manner. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay strong. And it is rightly answered. Time has come, now almost 6 months, we have to accept. Yesterday, today, our Honorable Prime Minister has been telling, jab tak vaccine nahi, tab tak dhilai nahi. No any kind of leniency in taking all precautionary measures. So, we must be very, very careful in protecting ourselves and the protecting others. We pray for everybody's best health and happiness to all. Before formal vote of thanks is given, 3 words I am using. Please accept situation, adapt to the situation, and prepare to convert this challenge into great opportunity. All our best wishes. Thank you. Principal Dr. Avinash Patil, Professor Wadekar, Dr. Hastak, and all my dear colleagues. Thank you very much for organizing this wonderful session. All our best wishes.
Thank you, sir, for your kind words. And thank you for telling us the introduction, which is not written on the paper, regarding Shri Kapil Pathareji, how he has worked hard and prepared himself to become a director. Sir, it is really very inspiring, and inspiring for our students also. Thank you very much, sir. So now, I would like to propose a formal vote of thanks at the end of this wonderful webinar on impact of COVID-19 life as an entrepreneur. Our today's speaker, respected Shri Kapil Pathareji, Director, VIP Clothings Limited, and member, Governing Council, BK Birla College. Sir, we really thank you for explaining our students the practical difficulties faced by entrepreneurs due to COVID-19 and how to turn the negative situation into positive, or the challenges into opportunities. Sir, your enterprise has started production of masks. So by doing this, you have set an example of survival of the fittest. Or we can say that the principle of change is constant and inevitable, even in business. So you are a good example, your company, and you have set for the other people. And our students really have to learn from this. So, sir, our students, that is would-be entrepreneurs, will definitely learn a lesson from your experiences. As you rightly said, that every problem has a situation, has a solution, and one has to focus only on solution. I would like to thank Dr. Naresh Chandra, Director Education, B.K. Birla College, who is a constant source of inspiration for all of us. I would also like to thank our principal, Dr. Avinash Patil, who is very keen to ensure the quality in every activity organized by the college. I would like to thank our Vice Principal Commerce Faculty, Shri Bipin Chandra Wadekar, who has guided us at every step in the successful organization of this webinar. We are indebted to our management and Shri O.R. Chitlangeji, our Chairman Shri O.R. Chitlangeji, who has provided us this digital platform of MS Teams to organize such kind of webinars even in this COVID-19 pandemic situation. So we feel that our college activities are going on normal. Only thing, instead of meeting one-to-one, we are organizing such activities on the MS Teams platform virtual. I also thank our Vice Principal Ismita Gupta Madam and Shri Vinod Rajput, Head Computer Science Department, who always try to provide us the technical support whenever we organize such kind of webinars. We are learning to be self-reliant while organizing this such kind of webinars, but still we need the support from them. And I also thank our faculty members who have joined, guests and faculty members who have joined this webinar. And I also, and last but not the least, I would like to thank our students for whom basically this webinar was organized, that they have to learn about entrepreneurship, how one has to work, how one has to consider so many things to become an successful entrepreneur. The journey of Shri Pathareji would not be very simple as he is telling us today. It must be, he might have to go through number of difficulties to become a director and to continue his business or to grow his business at a greater height day by day or year by year. So with these words, I would like to thank all my students. And students, you should always attend such programs which are organized for your development. Every time you cannot learn through the classroom. So this is learning beyond classroom, which is also essential to develop your personality and skills. So with these words, I thank you for attending this webinar. I thank you all for this attending this webinar.
Hello, students. Madam, regarding a link for feedback has been posted.
Yeah. Madam, I forgot to announce that. Yes, my dear students, the link for webinar, for the feedback of the webinar is shared with you. Kindly give your feedback by clicking on that link. You will get the feedback form and you are supposed to give the feedback of today's webinar. Please, all of you are requested to do the same. So you can see the link in the chat box, right? Yes, Vinod sir, please share the feedback link.
That is also there in Telegram group.
Yeah, the link is, my dear students, the link is also shared in the Telegram group. So either you can copy the link from there and give the feedback from the Telegram app, or you can copy the link from here and you can give the feedback. Okay, if you have any difficulty, you can definitely ask us in giving the feedback of this webinar. Thank you all.